Hello, and welcome back to Let's Play Dragon Quest Builders Demo. My name is Michael Batman Guy, and first thing I'm going to do is change the volume on this. I noticed it was definitely very loud. Message speed seemed okay. So, are you happy with these settings? Yeah, they'll do for now. I'll still be tweaking it as we go. This is not only the demo for the game, but it's kind of a demo for this LP. The other thing I noticed, I tried loading my other save, which had been a different style character, female character. I tested that out just to see if there was anything different in the game. So far, didn't notice anything. But when I loaded that save, let me see how to explain it. That was this older save here, slot 1. As a female character, but since this was the most recent one I played, I had the male character set, and apparently that's like not the character is not saved in the save file. It's just set for the whole game, at least as far as the demo is concerned. So I could load this world up and now I'd be the male character in the same world. It's very strange. So anyways, we're gonna load this one right from where we left off. Bam! There we are. So the Beacon of Hope is also the save point and spawn point. I also noticed if we run over here, just as an option here in the miscellaneous, this is how you of course exit the game. But you can also return to base, and so it's a emergency teleport, but you lose some of your items on the way. Yeah, let's not do that. We can of course go back and change the settings in here as well. And even learn how to play. And here's all the tutorial things that have popped up along the way. We've already seen those. Alright, buildings. We've got the blueprints, like Pippa's picture. And if you ever wanted to remember, what do I need for a basic bedroom? There you have it. Straw mattress and a light. And our crafting recipes are all listed here as well. So everything is there in the menu. It's very convenient. I just wish it wasn't the X button. Alright, back in, and we need to find the funny man, Pippa says, right? Have you found anyone to join our town yet? The man I told you about looked like a bit of an oddball, but I bet he'd be a really big help. Please, Bildrick, go around the other side of the mountains and bring him back! Alright, so we already know how to find the guy we're looking for. We need to make sure we have tools. Maybe I should whip up a spare oaken club before we go. Oaken club. Another one of those. Okay, and we got tons of healing cream. I think the thing we're really short on at the moment is food. I don't see any fruits around these trees here. Oh, hang on, I gotta equip that thing. That's gonna get annoying. Build this and then automatically add it. Make sure we use the damaged one first. Oh, here's some food. Oh, look at that. Oh, look at that. Fruit galore. And sticks. And unbreakable tree stumps. Okay. Take that. I like that things will turn see-through so you can actually tell where the character is. Pretty handy. The outline of when he's behind blocks. Oh, see his body there. That is a configuration in the options menu as well. And I'm definitely keeping it. It is handy to know where I am at all times. And we'll pick up some of these. Why not? Kind of gather the local resources here. I'm really trying to waste time until night. Although I guess you can sleep at any time, can't you? I'd like to go ahead and skip to the next day, just so I can head out early sunset. Oh, there's an extra dirt from our trench that we missed. Okay. Maybe I'll work on digging the trench. All kinds of good things over here. And we do always need more dirt blocks. Let's see, how far out did I put this? see, maybe go like here. We kind of have the stair step off the end, and we can have this one go up like that. Yeah, okay. Yeah. Liking this. This will be a good basic defense for the town. I'm probably gonna go halfway. The sign says monsters come from, looking at my compass here, the west. So that'll be where we need to concentrate our defenses. But just because they come from the west doesn't mean they won't try to sneak around and unique up on us from behind. That would be awkward. They manage that, so let's get a moat going here. Just while we wait for sunset. This is probably a complete waste of time. I'm either going way overboard or the demo is gonna wrap up before I know it, and it'll be like, why did you waste all your time doing that? You could have been done with the game already. Also, I'm wearing out my oaken club. The oaken club, I think there is actually still value in the cypress sticks because they use half as many resources. I'm gonna make two of these. So instead of turning two sticks into one club, we'll turn them into... Oh, right. Equip. Equip. Now, this way, because they use the same number of hits to destroy dirt blocks, it's kind of a waste of good materials to use that on... I'm gonna extend this out. Couple more. And then we'll go right here. See? Still two hits. Every time. And let me do the same thing here. Just need to put one of these back. And I think I hit one over here. Yep. Put that back. Okay. Back to town. Pippa's going to bed. Let's catch up. Alright. Snooze time. There we go. Try to shove your face into the wall. Good stretch. Okay. There we are. Alright. I'm going to put some of this dirt away. I do not need to be carrying all of that. Any of this for that matter. If we pick up any more on our way, that's fine. Nope. Good. Open the door. Thank you. Actually, we might need earth, but, I'll have... Alright, we're going out. Let's get our weapon. We're not gonna be destroying blocks. We're gonna be killing monsters that get in our way. Set off in... this direction? Is there... I think we can get around the mountains this way. I don't know if that... Does that use durability to break the leaves? Maybe we should stick with the stick. What is this? There's an old worn signpost here with the words My Pledge emblazoned at the top. There's a lot of writing underneath. Would you like to read it? Sure! How many years have passed since the vile and wicked Dragon Lord enshrouded our realm in darkness? Monsters roam the land unchecked, and even my dear home, the city of Cantlin, hath finally fallen. 'Twas but a matter of months after being robbed of the power to create that we did begin to lose our culture. Even now, fewer and fewer of our people are literate. For so long did we take that most dear and precious power for granted, that without it, we are undone. But if I cannot prevent humanity's decline, at least I can record it. To this end, I resolve to travel the lands of Alefgard and take note of what has befallen mankind. May this notice stand testament to my vow. I intend to collect the records of my journey into a book, which I shall title A Passage to Tantengel. I invite all who read this pledge to follow in my footsteps and seek out my story. May the goddess watch over thee in all thine adventures. Sir Reginald Augustus Greynus, Kentlin Brigade of Guards. Alright, well there you go. And some free white petals, I'll take them. Alright, so there's a little bit of the history of the world, part one, right there. In that pit. Alright, so what do we got around the mountain? I could maybe climb up that. Well, I could definitely climb up that. I can place blocks. I keep thinking, oh, I can't break the stone, but I can totally place stuff. No, don't. Just hit the grass. Here we go. Slime! Kill it! Kill it! Kill it dead! Yeah! Okay, so that one we got in two, the other one we got three. It's variable. We got a campfire here. That's cozy. Bonfire is burning brightly. It looks like it's been freshly stoked. Somebody must be nearby. Aha! A new marker. And, what's in the crate? Hey, free crate. Don't mind if I do. It's a decoration, cube-shaped container made for wooden planks. Score plus 100 points. Sweet! So we can go decorate our room. Back in town. Get back here, slime! Yeah! Yeah! Gotcha. Okay, up to club, down for sick, up for club. Yeah. Just bash him over the head. Ow! Oh, he hurt me. Oh no, I've taken damage. Oh dear, it's game over. We're done. We're all gonna die. Come here, you. Come on and fight me.
Yeah.
Take that. Haha. Okay. Just taking in the surroundings here. It's interesting, I've noticed that the tree placement is different. In the other save I've got by the campfire there, there is a tree next to it, where there is not here, so that leads me to believe that while the basic features of the world are static, they're not all randomly generated, there are some elements that are variable, like the trees. Let's go ahead and grab some extra sticks just to replenish our stock. Get out of here. Oh. Come here, you.
Get back here, slime. Ow.
Gotcha. Oh, oh. It's got uneven ground. That's probably easier. Ha. The wrong button there. Okay. Oh. That's not so bad. Ooh, look at this. This is neat. It's a little, we've got a building stump here. We can make cream torches and sticks. None of the actual block things. What do we have here? These ancient books are so difficult to read. Deciphering the Kentlin Chronicle might take much longer than I originally thought. The handwriting is so bad that Bildrick cannot summon up the will to read anymore. Oh my gosh, what is this? Okay, it's not a complete, house. We have some holes to fill in. There we go. That's better. Oh gosh, there's all kinds of things here. Take that, Drecky. Get a grass seed. Cool. Ow. Ow. Oh gosh, they like swarm. Oh, this is not good. Keep swinging. Keep swinging, lad. Does not get him. Oh. Okay, I went a little too far. The, should move my camera so I could see. Oh, and we can build stuff over here, just randomly. Okay. Should probably eat. I mean, these don't fill much. So, chow down. Oh, there's another stump. My goodness, there's a lot of those. Alright. Where are we heading? Quest is still that way. Lots of branches. There's some Drakis over there. Hello! Anybody there? Is somebody there? Those rotten monsters have buried me alive! They've completely covered me in earth and I can't get out! Please, whoever you are, get me out of here! Hurry, my child. Hold L1 or R1 to aim your attacks above or below you. Guide your blows carefully and free this man from his earthen tomb. Oh. Okay then. Switch to Cyber Stick and whack! 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 Gotcha! Sup, dude?
Phew! Free at last! I cannot thank you enough, young man!
Is he laughing? That's a little weird. But tell me, who exactly are you? I'm sure I would remember such a funny-looking face.
Hey!
What? You say you're building a town near here?
By my bushy beard! That is wonderful news! Let me help! Let me join your city and help to rebuild it!
Hmm?
What are you pulling that face for? You look like you just swallowed an insect!
Because you're weird, dude.
Well, you may make whatever strange face you like. I'll find my way to your town whether you like it or not! I am Rolo, the proud owner of that most venerable of books, the Kentland Chronicle. I assure you that it and I will prove invaluable to this new city of yours. Now, lead the way!
Hooray! More party members! Alright, let's have a look at... Man, this guy is... freaky looking. Okay, well, I'm gonna take this free torch, because it's not doing anyone any good over here. And, oh, what is that? Ooh, fruit. Huh. This is interesting. There's some kind of, like, ancient ruins here. Neat! There's nothing to, like, examine. Anything. We can... Interestingly enough, even the grass on the ground is indestructible. See that? Ba-ching, ba-ching. Not affected by our stick. Okay. Okay, ooh, what is this? A kind of mushroom? Clump of mushrooms. Okay. Alright, alright. Sounds tasty. Ooh, it's getting towards dark. Hang on. Okay, I wanted to grab these things because we'll probably not be over here again for a long time. But we need to move! Bucket man, come on, Rolo! Faster! Oh dear, there's scary noises in the woods. Scary noises! Hurry up, we can make it to that little hut. We can take a nap. Or I can take a nap. You can fend for yourself. Where'd it go? Oh, right here. Sleepy time! You, take first watch. Alright. Good. Up and ready to go. Boy, the days are short. I miss when we just had infinite time. There's none of this day-night nonsense, but, you know, that's part of the survival of the game, right? This grass. This other grass. I'm using the stick, right? Yeah, okay. I'm pretty sure he can actually help in combat. Let me see if I can... Whoa! Okay, speaking of combat! Chimera! Oh my gosh! And a fastly tied fan of fluttering feathers instantly transports you to your base.
Aha!
Genius! I came up with an idea. Ooh, he needs to heal. Some damage there from a fireball in the back. Oh my gosh. Talk about unfair. Just.
Surprise bomb attack. Bam!
Gotcha! And we got Milk Blossom Bud. Okay. Don't know what we do with that. Clear out the rest of these slimy goobers. Ah! Another Milk Blossom Bud. Okay. Take me to your leader. I mean, you're down. I'm working on it, dude. Let's grab that. That. Grass. We're gonna need a lot of this. So I'm taking all of it while we're here. Really don't care about this line. Really not much of a threat. Not any more chimeras over here, are there? Oh dear. Yep, and it's headed this way. Bam! Got you. You jerk. That's what you get for messing with Bildrick. Who is not a hero, but he is here to save the world. Not sure how that... Oh, really? Don't concern yourself with the slimes, man. Gotta get to town. I wonder if he healed himself. It looks like his little HP bar disappeared now. Does he naturally regenerate some HP, or... Can I... Let's see, I can look at my items. I cannot, like, switch to see his status or anything, so... It's just a temporary NPC. Take me to town. Okay! We're in town! Check it out, it's got a great flag and everything. My word! Just look at this place! Hooray! New friend! Yay! My friend! Yay! Alright. She's always talking down to me. Yay! You found someone to join our town! Yeah. It was kind of dangerous. What's that? You think he seems a bit shady? You might be right there. That's why I avoided him in the first place. When I first saw him, he was giggling to himself and stroking this enormous book. But he's got a beard. He must be pretty dependable, right? And he must be really clever, too. I mean, he's got such a big, bushy beard, after all. Yeah, that's totally what beards mean. But anyway, now that we've found a new friend, we can all work together to make this the best city in the whole of Alefgard. You know, if the rest of Alefgard is anything like the condition we found this place in, I don't think that'll be too hard to be the best. just throwing that out there. Okay, before we talk to him, we've got some tidying up to do. Let's put all that away. Put the blue goo away. Grass seed. Sprouting seed of bright green grass. Grows grass on nearby earth floors. Ooh, okay, that'll be handy when we want to greenify some stuff. Cora lily bud. The bud of a bloom with pretty pink petals. Purchases a Cora lily flower when planted. Score plus 15 points. Okay, so we can plant flowers. Awesome. How about the mushroom? A fungus found on the forest floor that has a slight sour flavor. You can also put it down for bonus points. Okay, why would you want to decorate your house with mushrooms? I don't know. We got two chimera feathers, a feather filled with an unearthly energy. And the milk blossom bud. The bud of a bloom with pure white petals produces a milk blossom flower when planted. Oh, so kind of like the... pink one there. And I guess I'll put that away for now. Tidy this up. The crate. Boom! 100 points. Oh yeah. Isn't this awesome? Hey, Pippa. Thanks for finding new friends to come and live in our city, Bildrick. Rollo must be a really clever man. Silly people don't have beards as bushy as that. Now that more people are moving in, we're going to need more beds for everyone to sleep on. Poor old Rollo shouldn't have to sleep on the floor. He'll get his beard dirty. I guess you have a point there. What does he think of the matter? He's still just so happy to be here. See if I can get the camera to zoom in here. There we go. Hey, Rollo. How's it going? By my bristly brows, this town is positively brimming with life! There's two of us, dude. It's not that big. Why, I do believe that the Cantlin Chronicle describes this very place. It's the perfect location to bring the legendary city of Cantlin back to life. And how are we gonna do that? Oh, my mention of the legendary tome piques your interest, does it? The Cantlin Chronicle is an invaluable volume of ancient knowledge, passed down in my family over countless generations.
It is many hundreds of years old, and its pages tell of mankind's hapless history and the lost art of creation and construction. Deciphering this ancient text could reveal secrets vital to the restoration of this once great city. Our meeting is no mere coincidence, Bildrick. I assure you, we are destined to rebuild this magnificent town together.
Okay. Cool. And he's gonna go, straight to the workshop. Oh, yeah! What did we get out of that? Pippa's picked. Oh, I put that there. Oh, she made a whole chest! Oh my gosh. Take that. Thank you. Free chest. Yes, please. Should we just install it here? We'll just have some, extra storage. Boom. There we go. The same thing she said before. Need more beds. But not an actual quest. He's busy whipping up something. We should give him a sort of bedroom or something. I could probably clear this up, actually. That's actually super simple. Boom. 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 Get this stupid rock out of here. Bam! Decimated. So we should probably just repair everything along here. Like so. Go. Oh, and yeah, this is our western wall. This definitely needs to be fixed. Oh, wrong button. There we go, that's better. Although why we then have like double, I'm not sure. Stupid rock, get out of here. I'm gonna clean up this town. Like that, and you can just have a little overhang. I'm not sure what to do with this room. I don't know if I want to raise it up a level to be even with all of this, or keep it down lower. Like this could just... Okay. We're gonna come around here. Like that. And jump up. Place. Oh. Place. Place. Here we go. We can just jump. There we go. Get out of here, grass. Okay. Cool. So we've got our bridge to the gate there. Probably shouldn't be a straight line. It'd be easier to defend. But I honestly don't know what I'm talking about at the moment. I don't know what's easier to defend. I don't know how we're going to defend this. I don't know what kind of attacks we are anticipating. I have not a clue. I'm thinking that should go. Probably shouldn't be able to climb up over the wall from the outside. But, you know, we'll just, get out of the way. This is another, good reason to fill in these gaps so people don't keep climbing up. Pippa, get out of here. Trying to patch the holes in the walls. Okay, now every wall is too high. We don't need that. Good, we could put in door here. Oh, can't fit a door there or there. Actually, you know what? We'll just fill all of that in that way. Clear out the rock. Just kind of clean up duty today. And since I can't destroy this rock, obviously we're gonna have to go over here. Good spot for a door there. We're gonna need a lot of doors. Yeah. I know, and poor Rolo. Hey! Dude,
Was it truly you who constructed these buildings? If that were true, it would mean that you have the power to build new things. Yeah, did I not mention that? A gift that mankind lost so long ago. Could it be that you are the builder of whom the Cantlin Chronicles speaks? The legendary figure blessed with the power of construction? Bah, of course not. If the builder had a face like that, I'd eat my own beard. Well, let me get you a knife and fork, my friend. Ah, yes, Bildrick, I nearly forgot. The path across the mountains between this town and the place where you and I first met was dreadfully treacherous, wasn't it? Well, the Cantlin Chronicle describes a special tool that can be crafted from the feathers of the chimeras that dwell amid those mountains. A most convenient contrivance that lets you travel at blinding speed and be back at your base in the blink of an eye. Of course, if you truly were the builder of legend, I'm sure you would have no trouble creating this item and showing it to me. Bildrick, my child, you need only lay your hands upon a new material to discern what items can be built from it. The chimeras you seek dwell at the foot of the mountains. Fast by this place. Grammatically, is this like an old Englishy kind of thing to say? The mountains fast by this place? Use your compass to find them that you might not lose your way. Right, new quest marker. Thank you, and alright. Jerk butt stole my bed. It's okay, we can make another one. It's just grassy leaves. In fact, why don't we make a second? And actually, I place them. No, I don't like it there. I like it here. A proper room. Right. Well, guess we'll have to make a door then, won't we? Yeah, we're gonna make a door. Okay. It's a good thing I've got that spare torch on me. Well, how am I supposed to know? Okay, and torchy time, torchy. I like it to be somewhat centered. Corner might make more sense, but fine, I'll sleep here now. She was right. You know, it wasn't a quest, so I kind of ignored her, but Pippa was right. We've learned our lesson. Do not ignore Pippa's words. When Pippa says, make the man a bedroom, we make the man a bedroom, and that's great, Pippa. You just, how'd he get out? Just hop up the chest. It's way faster than going out the door. Oh, I should have looked in here. Did anybody make anything useful? Free sticks! Sorry, broken branches. No, actually, that's pretty good, because, I don't know if you've noticed, but they're not, like, respawning out here. Get out of here, rock. I don't know, I want to keep some of these for decoration. We can't make rocks. Or the grass things, for that matter. Eh, we'll clear these ones, though. But, yeah, none of this stuff regenerates. It appears on the ground right now, and I don't know how to get more of it when we run out. If we run out. That would be a little bit ridiculous to go and harvest literally all of the resources in the known world. But the known world is not that big. We can go, you know, this is back towards the mountains. Right there's... Right at the bottom you can see that first signpost area. A lump up here, and then there's this coast. And let's see, there's that peninsula there, water there. And then over on this side, we can see clearly in the distance the mountain range. And so we're kind of boxed in. It's a small area to start with. All right, make something with chimera feathers. Right, I have two of them. Right? Got two feathers in. Oh my gosh, I need to eat. Like a lot. Good thing I went and gathered some berries. I don't know what happens when you run out. Maybe I should test that. This is the demo, after all. This is the time to test things. So we don't kill ourselves in the real game.
Well, the... I shouldn't say the real game. This is real, but the full game. That's what I mean. Any chimeras? I heard a ding. Somebody dinged. What the... Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, we're dead. Yeah, two at once.
Yeah.
Oh, we got him. Well. Oh, snap.
Ha!
Missed me! You jerk. I beat you over the head with a spiked wooden club. That I built with my bare hands out of a tree branch. And the Drakis don't seem to bother you too much either if you just don't run into them. Alright. Progress. We got three feathers on our... So is this... This is like another room of the base, right? 220 points for this basic bedroom. I wonder if there's a way to find... Residence max HP. Is there a... There's not like a... A base... management thing. Stonemason's workshop. Any luck crafting Chimera's feathers into a certain special something? Oh. Oops. Yeah, I know, thanks. Thanks, guys. This game loves to help. Chimera wing! Build up! Boom. Oh, we get three of those? Wow. Okay, this is easier than I thought. Hi! That's the table. Talk to the man.
Goddess above! This is a chimera wing! It is just as the Kentland Chronicle describes. And there is no doubt about it. Within you dwells the long-lost power of construction. You really are the builder.
Took you long enough. How do you think this place... You just thought all this was here?
Ever since the light was lost to us, and the realm plunged into darkness, the people of Aleph Guard have waited for this day to come. The day that benevolent Rubus would send the Builder to save us.
But I'm not a hero.
Bildric, my child, you needed only to touch a chimera's feather to know what you could build from it. Seek out more materials and speak to those around you, and your knowledge is sure to expand even further. Keep a keen eye on your surroundings, my child. If you should see anything that you have never seen before, be sure to collect it.
Like those mushrooms.
Bildric, my friend, you and I have two vital tasks ahead of us. Firstly, we must complete the glorious restoration of the once great city of Kentlin.
Agreed.
And secondly, we must unravel the mystery of what terrible tragedy brought this town to ruin. This place was once girdled all about by fearsome fortifications, tall turrets and towers to keep the monsters at bay. It is even said that a great golem once watched over the city, keeping all inside safe from harm.
That would be amazing. Can we build golems?
But those citadels and strongholds were completely obliterated and nothing remains of Canton but ruins. How could such a wretched fate have come to pass? As a proud son of Cantlin, I plan to uncover the mystery of what befell my ill-starred ancestors. No doubt that with your powers and my book, it is only a matter of time before the truth becomes clear. We're all counting on you, Bildric.
This guy is creepy. Like, he just laughs for no reason. We got four branches. Yay! Claps for Bildric. Alright, Pippa? What'd you have in mind now?
You know, Bildric, I've been so starving lately, I could eat my own head! All this building and inventing is hungry work! So I've been thinking...
Uh-oh, here we go.
If we had something to cook with, we could make all sorts of delicious, nutritious meals. What do you say? Can you think of something you could build to cook things on? If you do think of anything, put it in a room with a chest so we can store the delicious dishes we make. So, yeah, make us a room to cook in.
Cooking, you say? Aha! I have an idea! I call it the cook fire. A simple stand built above a bonfire used for making mouth-watering meals. Counts as a light source, can be used to cook food. Score, plus 150 points. Oh yeah. Building a room from the ground up. Alright, so a room must have 2-block-high walls around, a door, and a light source. Gather all the ingredients you need and try building one. Okay. So, here's my question. Can a room use other walls? Like this one. Can we just kind of block this in? Of course we need room for the door. Go here, or do we want to go... I'm using my club, dang it. No, you missed, Bildrick. Just the one, this game. I like the targeting reticle. I wish there was a way to just activate that. After you hit something with a stick, you gotta switch back to the earth. You gotta hit that so we get the square where we're actually gonna put something. Okay. Center the door, and should probably fill in these corners, like so. Need a door, again. Nobody built the door for me, did they? No, not yet. Gotta wait for the end of the day again. Straw door, please. Thank you. And go over here, I've got some spare torches in the box. I'm gonna take, I just need one, so no point in being greedy. Bam! Open says me. Bam! Build an empty room! Oh yeah! Okay. I did the thing like you said. Now we... It'd be nice if there was a quests menu. So we gotta build that cook fire. Cook fire. Broken branches? Got those. Grassy leaves? Got those. One bonfire. Don't got that. So I'll build this first. Sticks and goo. No. Cook fire. Build! Watch out! See the little like sparkle in his eye before he whipped that up? Okay. Alright, so now we have ourselves a kitchen. Ooh. Okay, yeah. Along the wall there. That'll work. And a chest. Oh, hey. I just so happen to have a spare chest lying around. Bam! Crude kitchen get. 200 points! Oh yeah! And we leveled up! Woo! I don't know what that means. It means Pippa will run in and love us forever. That's what that means. Yay, Pippa! Blimey, you did it! Now she's British! Blimey, you did it! You made me a place to cook! Now I'll be able to make all sorts of scrummy food. Thank you, Bildrick! And that chest is perfect. If I make anything really, really tasty, I'll put it in there so you can try a bit, too. Right. Got some plumberries. Awesome. Hang on. Let me get the, residents will cook food and put it in the chest. So kind of like the workshop, we're just going to get free stuff at the end of the day. Don't mind if I do. Alright, what can we make? Ooh, fried egg. We need a monster egg. Speckled egg, fried, sunny side up. Okay. I don't know how we get monster eggs. Shrooms on a stick. Just needs mushrooms. How does this not require a stick? This is just shrooms. Scrumptious skewer of barbecued mushrooms. Fills hunger meat bar 20%! Oh my gosh, that's twice as good as the berries. So... yeah.
Make two servings of those. Sizzle them up. Mmm, tasty. Alright. Okay, now that it's getting dark, let's see where they go. Pippa should, of course, go to her original spot. Let's see if Rolo, comes over here to this other bedroom. You know, we can turn this into a another one as well. Is it the same? No, it's like one block less as wide. I don't know how to say that eloquently. Well, well, well. By my bulbous belly, it seems we have a kitchen now. This creative power of yours is a wonderful thing. I wonder if your culinary skills are equally exemplary. What say you test them out and make me something to eat? Make yourself something. What? Make it yourself? That's exactly what I said. You'll build a whole kitchen for Pippa, but you won't even make me a single measly meal? Well, yeah, I like Pippa. Bildrick, you wound me. I thought we were friends. Sure. You keep thinking that. By the way, I should mention that I saw some delicious-looking orange mushrooms growing down by the water's edge. Wait, hang a minute. Have I been saying it wrong this whole time? Mushrooms? Mushrooms? If I build you a bath, will you go for a wash? Mushrooms growing down by the water's edge. Maybe you should be like a Sean Connery. I'm sure you could make a terrific meal out of a fine ingredient like that. Three servings should do the trick. Do we have an agreement, friend? Bring me some cooked mushrooms. It does say cooked mushrooms. Shoot, do mine say cooked mushrooms? Shrooms on a stick. Okay, that doesn't help. I need to find fresh ones. But first, I'd like another door, please. And got torches. Should pick those up. Okay, I'll just keep all the torches with me. I'm gonna go make another empty room. Oh, bam! And torch time. See, if I do the beds just the same, this torch is gonna have to be over here. Ta-da! 60 points. How much was this one? This is two. Oh, because it's a bedroom, right. It actually has beds. It's useful for something. That one's just a storage closet. Okay. You went there. Gosh darn it! Get. I don't. How do I. I broke it. Oh dear. No, wait. Pippa, come back! Pippa, come back! Oh, okay. Nope, I'm just gonna sleep. I ruined it. My bad. Guys, I'm sorry. Let's try not break them. I mean, I got him up. Kicked him out of there, but might have kicked Pippa out of here as well. That's not good. Hooray! Back to a basic bedroom. Oh, this is so confusing. Because it's gotta be. It has to have the two in order to count as a bedroom. And. Wish you could, like, assign them to rooms. Okay. And in my last playthrough, my testing play, he did go over here. I made a room over here, and he went over there and slept in it. And I don't know if it's because I got that extra room down before the sunset when we were there, and so he actually had the choice. Here he was like, well, I'm just going to take the only one available. And so we went in there and... Whatever, is there any stuff in here? No. Nothing in there. I guess it has to... It has to have been built for a whole day to count. We just got more broken branches. Okay, that's great. Alright, I need more mushrooms. Or marshrooms, or whatever they're called. Need to figure out what they're called. Are they mushrooms? Are they mushrooms? There's some. By the water. This water, this is shallow water. We can splash in that. Not a problem. It is mushroom. Okay. My bad. I was saying it wrong. Didn't realize it till I saw his dialogue there. Mushrooms. I mean, we might as well grab the berries. Maybe we can eventually cook the berries into, well, cooked berries. What else is over here? We need to be on the lookout for cool new ingredients. And sticks. Of course, we have that quest that's off. Oh, no, that's him. Him? Saying go get, chimeras? We already did that. Oh, I know what I'm thinking of. Hang on. I'll explain it once we're out of this, neck of the woods. Yeah, Draggy! Get out of here. Need those berries. To do, just gonna collect some stuff. Really don't need as many branches. We have an infinite source of branches. Stupid stump blocking my way. Oh, they drop flowers. That's cool. Let's stop beating up on the Drakis. Try to save my health. If I can avoid having to use the creams, I will. Alright, let me get up on this hill and show you what I was talking about earlier. So, when it asks for go get chimeras, I went back here, because that's where we had been. But anybody who actually looked at the compass would have noticed, hey, the quest marker was over there somewhere. Yes, that was true. That's what I did in the other... my first time playing. Because I ended up going over there, because that's where the quest had to go. Like, okay, I don't know what is different. But, oh, you can build these on here too. Okay. So any, like, you can make items and equipment. You just can't make the furniture-y things on a stump. Okay, but that's good that there's these stumps out in the middle of nowhere, so you can craft up the chimera wings you collect. See? These guys? They're over here. Chimera. Oh, dear. He dinged. Nope, 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 nope. None of that now. Stop. Stop it. No fireballs. Or fire, or... shoot, this is Dragon Quest. What's the name it called? Frizz? I'm not sure. Ooh, look, more mushrooms. Cypress stick, go. Oh, do not fall in this water. If you can't see the bottom, you can't swim in it. You will drown and die. And it's not pleasant. Okay, I mean, it's not that bad, but... yeah, it's not good. Don't just jump in there. As I found out. Ooh, there's some mushrooms over here. And another, like, pit with bones in it. This is creepy. This is creepy. There's all kinds of, like, open graves around here. Oh, I don't even need a bridge. I can just jump across this gap. Does that mean the monsters can too? Do I need to make my moat 3 wide? I am not inclined to do that. Okay, I'm going to equip more mushrooms. I'm just going to cook them all. Because I have nothing else to do with these mushrooms. Sorry, mushrooms! I'm going to ruin that every time. Marvelous work! I'm a master chef. Bildrick, my friend, do I detect the succulent scent of freshly roasted mushrooms? The fragrance alone is a mellow melody of mouth-watering flavors. By my growling gizzard, these shall make a magnificent meal. Come now, hand them over. Quick, quick, quick. All right, here, you can have 3. Marvelous work, Bildrick. We shall have to rename you the Cooker. The Cantlin Chronicle covers a wide range of topics. The chapters concerning the preparation of hearty, healthy meals are of particular... Hey, you know... pardon? You want to see it? Yourself? The Cantlin Chronicles with your own 2 eyes? I'm sorry, Bilgic, but that book is a priceless family heirloom. I can't just go parading it around in front of anyone that asks. And besides, the tome is written in an ancient and cryptic script. There's no way that you or anyone else would be able to read it
What little knowledge I myself have gleaned from it has taken years of painstaking study. However, I have not a single doubt that this book holds the key to restoring this city to its former greatness. I shall not rest until I have deciphered each and every one of its secrets. But fear not, my friend. I will not keep these secrets to myself. Soon as I make a breakthrough in my studies, you will be the first to know. And as for these mushrooms, it is only fair that you should taste the fruits of your labors, too. Take this as a token of our everlasting friendship. Oh, he gives one back. Sharing is caring. Alright, Rolo. You're okay. Even if you're a nitwit that can't actually read, and I totally can, I don't know how to communicate that to you because... Yeah, that hut back there with the terrible handwriting, that was his. If you didn't figure that out, that was his. He is semi-illiterate. He's... I know kindergartners that can write better than him, so... Pippa? Are you... Is that what you call, cooking? Okay, there we go. Now she's like... Oh, there's smoke, too. Did you see that? Camera, can you... There we go. Oh, we missed it. Pippa, get back to the kitchen. Back to the cooking. There we go. Yeah, see? All kinds of extra steam effects. Filling it up and getting all foggy. But before, she was, like, crouched to the ground, like, scraping dirt together. It was weird. Anything in here? No, just the plants. Okay. What are we doing now? We got the mushrooms. We now want to see where everyone is actually going to go to bed. She is going to climb on the walls. He is going... I'm going to eat this. That is tasty. Alright, guys. Nighttime. Time for bed. Chop, chop. Where are we going to go? Where are we going to go? You're wandering over there. Into the corner of nothing. Great, just stare at a wall. Good job. It's okay, I'm doing the exact same thing. If anyone were to come by like, hi, I heard you're in charge. Why are you standing in the corner with your face smashed up against a dirt wall? Are you weird? Yeah, a little bit. Just waiting. For the darkness to come and everybody run. Oh, shadows are moving again. The shadows are moving. Time, and they're both going over there. Gosh darn it! No! No! Bad! Man. Wrecked it. Okay, we're gonna have to rectify this. Gonna have to... Now they're both leaving. And I can slow him down, maybe. Nope, that slows everybody down. What? Have I finished reading that book yet? Learn some patience, young man. I made it quite clear that you would be the first to know of any secrets I uncover. Deciphering the Kentland Chronicle will take time, Bildrick, and our work on restoring the city has only just begun. I suggest that, while I continue my studies, you labor to rebuild this city to its former greatness, and prove yourself the builder you claim to be. By completing rooms and placing within them the items you create, you can increase the level of your base. But be wary that you do not place your decorations more than 2 blocks above the floor, for such items will not count towards your point total. Now go, my child. Fill your town with buildings, and those buildings with furnishings, and see that your new home flourish. Bildrick, pay attention. Now, can you think of anything we could use to decorate all these new rooms you're about to build? Decoration? Yeah, I think I've got an idea. Wonderful work, Bildrick. I am impressed. Not only are you the legendary builder, but it seems your powers are becoming even greater. I don't know what I just thought of. I didn't get a little... Oh! She, like, froze in midair. Okay, if you need to pause the game, start a conversation. Simple as that. And wow, is it dark out here.
Dude, you're a little close. Does the word personal space mean anything to you?
Bildrick, my child, no matter how many monsters you defeat, you will grow no stronger. Only by the weapons you wield and the armor you wear will your might as a warrior increase. You are the builder, my child, and it is by building this base that your true strength will be revealed.
I'm sorry to say, though, that I've made scant progress at deciphering the Cantlin Chronicle. I dare say it will be some time still before...
By my sensitive ears, did you hear that?
No? Hear what? Oh ho ho. Here we are.
Eureka! Bildrick works out how to build a pot! An earthen urn that can be used to store one's personal property.
Not actually. Spoiler alert, you can't put things in it. Decorate the rooms in your base with furniture and other items to add points to your base meter. Okay? Take it to a whole new level. I wonder... If we had managed to complete that... Okay, shoot. Put this back. Put the torch back. If we had managed to, complete, that quest, because now we want to increase the level before we had bumped up to level 2. Okay. If I... Hang on, I have an idea. I don't want to wreck both of those, or either one of them, because if I drop below 2, it will no longer be a bedroom. But if I build an extra one... Let's see if this will work here. Go in here. Place an extra one there, and then very carefully... Whack! Get out of here. Oh, I think it's working. I think it's working.
He's leaving. Perfect.
Put it down. And then... He's going off to here. He's like, oh. This is no good, and he doesn't detect that there was another mat there, he just goes to the next available bedroom. Perfect! Aha, I'm a genius! Okay, and we don't need that. Still basic bedroom. Everybody's still sleeping. Alright, go to sleep. Woo! That was a long night. Alright. Okay, so we've got kitchen now, we've got the bedrooms all sorted out properly this time. Yeah, you would love to just jump on up there. We could... I guess we can move the crate over there, I suppose. Or... Oh, wait, let's check. Did we get any food here? Hey, a fried egg! Alright, fills hunger meter by 20%, so it's... just as good as the shrooms on a stick. So I'm just gonna stick with the shrooms. Because they'll, you know, stack with each other. This... I don't need that. That I need. That I need. That. Don't need. That I need. That I need. That I need. Yes. That will stick with. Put the flowers away. Put the feather away. Put the seed away. Tidy this. Tidy that. Check for furniture. We have a chest! Sweet! Why don't we build an extra straw mattress? And go turn this into another... You know what? I think... Hang on. So as not to interfere with Beardy Man's sleep schedule, we'll continue to keep an extra... Okay, this is going to be very tricky. Just the torch. There we go. Okay. Bedroom destroyed. Oh, wait. Shoot, it did not go as planned. I'm gonna do that. And... maybe put the torch there. There we go. Okay, although the extra torch adds additional points. There we go. That. And put the torch there. Take that one. Everything is nice and symmetrical. Good. Okay, did anybody see those pots on the list? Oh, there it is. Right out in the chest. Pot. Earth and goo. Okay. We're just gonna glue together some dirt. We've got plenty of earth. Got a good amount of glue. I don't want to do as many as possible. That would use up all our... Oh, who am I kidding? We'll just go kill some slimes after this. Let's go pots. Okay. I know what that sword above his head means. I'm ignoring it. Badness. That's what that is. Boom. Plus 50 points. Oh. Put it in the corner. Boom. Plus 50 points. Alright. Boom. Plus 50 points. Oh yeah. Just decorate all the things here. Yep. 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 There. There. Should we put some in the kitchen? Got 9 of these things. Need to go, like, everywhere. Put it on top of the crate. Haha! Fancy. Another one there. Just make this the... super room. I don't know what else to put over here. And you know what? Here's all my dirt. Yeah. Let's go ahead and... Okay, definitely want to put one there. We go... Nope.
Ah.
That, then we can put a thing here. And I think we could just make this a whole room, right? I'll have to seal it off. Can we do 2 doors per room? How does that work? How many doors can I make? Ooh. Make as many as possible. That's gonna be 2. I can do one down here. Boom. And let's see. Do one here. And the light source. Okay, that counts. Sweet. 140 points. Is the score based on the size, I wonder? Let me see. These rooms have the exact same amenities, they're just a different size. So this is 270. And this one is 320, yes. So this is, what, 1, 2, 3 more blocks internally? 270 to 320, that's a 50-point difference. That doesn't make any sense. Oh, no. No, this has the extra pot, that's right. Okay, that would be the 50-point difference. So, no? Okay, now we have this. If I could just make one more door.
Only if only I could make one more door.
We gotta find some grass. Hunt for grass. And slimes. We gotta kill some of these guys, get some goo. There we go. Restock our goo supply. Grass, grass, grass. Now we'll stick with the stick. There we go. There's one. There's 2. I told you we needed a lot of grass. And they can automatically build furniture, so they might automatically just build a door or a bedroll that uses the grass, but I'm impatient. I need materials. There's some. Just go exploring, right? We gotta check out the rest of the world. Oop, there's more.
Yeah.
Gotcha. Okay. We might as well take the sticks while we're here. Just grab everything. Big greedy little buggers. It's over here. Let's investigate this peninsula. It's got a sign. Oh, we gotta go read the sign. And check for grass and flowers. And sticks. I'll take that. Give me that. What's the sign say?
There's a message written on the signpost.
I wonder if this is the Chronicle dude. What was his voice again?
The bridge that once connected these islands was destroyed by the monsters. I fear the power to cross lakes and rivers in this way is no longer within mankind's grasp.
Oh, look! More things! With all kinds of cool stuff. Oh dear, it's getting dark. Getting dark. Okay, but real quick. Aim down. And here, just aim. Can't we just bridge? Nope! Repelled by a strange force, invisible plot wall! As the good old H.C. Bailey would say. Yep, you literally cannot leave, even though you could, you know, bridge your way over, theoretically. The game does not let you. There's no escape. Vicious slimes! I will destroy you! Alright, another... Oh! These are pink petals. It was kind of hard to tell in the dim light here, but yeah. They're definitely different. See him on the hotbar there. It's like, oh! Oaken club, man. Oh dear. Oh, it's dark. I cannot see home. Oh, there it is. Ooh, it's like the fog sets in. Oh, that's creepy. No, I see bubbles. Anybody see that? The slimes go to sleep. Oh, that's cute. Can we, like, sneak attack them? Bam! Okay, we can. That's kind of cool. Nighttime isn't so bad. For now. Yeah, I don't see anything out here that's gonna kill us, so we should probably go to bed anyways. Alright, is everybody in their proper place?
He's not here! Why are you
Oh, I'm dying of hunger.
Gosh darn it, would you stop taking my spot?
Pull the same trick. This is. I'm not gonna go place this in another bedroom. This is gonna be our spare. This guy, get out of here. There you go. Jump over and into the kitchen. That's kind of funny. It's right. Sleep over there. Pippa, why do you let him do this? Do you like him better than me? Is it the beard? Probably the beard. You saw the way she looks at him. She's like, he's got a cool beard. It must be nice. Must be clever. Like, I am the builder. I'm here to save the world. I'm not a hero, but I'm here to save the world. Okay, so, I guess I don't... Peachy petals plucked from a colorful coral lily. If I could have made something, I would have thought of it by now. So I guess I can't make anything with those. That's disappointing. But we can... this stuff away. We can make some more doors now. Had to waste some of them on extra mattress. It's okay. It's okay, we got two doors now. We can make another room. And, oh, we could even actually... Let's do this. Here we go. We just need... Oh, am I out of torches? Okay, we'll make more torches. Torch, 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 torch. Torch. Okay, since we get five of them for one stick and one goot, definitely more efficient than the bonfire. Bonfire provides no real additional benefit. So, we'll start with the closet. Okay. Boom! It's a room! It's a teeny tiny room! We're 60 points. And this is, another room! Worth 160 points. Okay, there's definitely, something. Maybe when they transform into bedrooms, they switch to that default 220 or whatever it is. What was it? What is this one? This minus 50 is a basic bedroom, right? Yeah, 220 for the basic bedroom. This could be anything. I don't know. But we should decorate it. Should put some pots in here. And maybe put a pot in here, or maybe in the storage closet. There we go. Is that in the way? No. No, because once it's open, you can literally walk right through it. Okay. A lot of doors. But I'm just trying to make use of the existing walls. So I think this seems somewhat sensible. I might make some walls three high just so everybody isn't jumping over them, but I don't know, that's kind of convenient to get around. Just saying. You don't need to make a roof, so don't waste your time with that. It's literally a waste of resources. Haha! I love how everyone's using that shortcut. Alright, what do you got? Another egg. Awesome. And in here, this is like Harvest Moon, checking your chickens. More chests. Okay. Should we just put a spare chest in here? Plus 50 points. Okay. Yeah, chests are worth 50 points, so... go for it. Put down some extra storage there. Plus 50 points. Better than the... Straw bed? Straw mattress? Ooh. Because that's 30 points and it takes up two blocks of space, so... Yeah, I would say pots are the most efficient because it's made with dirt and goo. But three branches for a chest isn't too bad either. And we got... Oh, more flowers. Why don't we plant more flowers? I need to eat! Ah! I don't look up in that corner at all. I'm too used to Minecraft, I guess. Everything's down below. I'm looking at my bar of items here and not seeing this bouncing hunger meter that says, hey, you need to eat. You need to eat. We got to hungry. It was like all flashing red. I have no idea what was going to happen to us if we didn't do anything about it, but let's plant some flowers. Boom. Did we get points? Nothing popped up here. Let's see, 255. Should we just alternate? 270. Oh, there it is, the way down underneath the item. Go. Awesome. And I'm gonna go up here and gotcha. Okay. Got a line of flower. I would like this one to be pink. But, you know, you can't have everything. So we'll just save them for later on. Yeah, you can't. There is no putting things in the pots. They lie about storing stuff. Alright. That's pretty good. Pippa has nothing for us. The only thing left is actually the battle that he's suggesting here. Well, we'll go ahead and read it. And then I'll say no.
Bildrick, I have the most terrible tidings. I know not what has driven them to it, but the monsters plan to attack our great city in force. We must protect Cantlin at all costs. Bildrick, you must prepare our defenses against the coming assault. But fear not, I shall fight by your side, my friend. I shall do my duty by protecting dear Pippa and our beloved home from harm.
Rollo speaks the truth, my child. The vicious beasts that dwell hereabouts are heading here in droves. This town is the seed of all Alefgard's restoration. It must not be allowed to fall at the hands of the monsters. With an oaken club in hand and enough healing cream to tide you through the onslaught, you must drive back the Dragon Lord's foul followers. My child, are you ready to face this fight?
Nope. And that's the end of that. So we can just outright refuse the quest, build up our defenses like, say, a trench. You know, I think that'd be handy. I have yet to lull any of these stupid slimes to fall into it to see if this is actually useful or not. Come on. Bring it on. Free goo. Alright. And we can make a ton of healing creams with all the white petals we've got. We've got a lot of those. And yeah, I was gonna finish that. I don't know. Do I want to make like more wall? I don't know. I definitely want to eliminate like this. Okay. That is what I meant. That's better. Okay, kind of fill that in there. But they can't climb up from the outside. Okay. And, oh, maybe solidify that corner. Just, feels a little better. Right. I'm thinking this is a good place to wrap up this episode, and I'll come back and we'll take on the monster onslaught next time and see what else the demo has to offer. I don't know what's beyond that. Like I said, this is as far as I've gotten. This is actually more than I've done, at least with the town here. There is really no better way. I guess I could turn these into bedrooms. That would increase their points by quite a lot. Those are the only rooms I really know how to... Recipe? No. Buildings, room recipes. Bedroom is worth... Oh, it's worth 100 points. A kitchen is worth 150. And that, but I can't make a mason's workstation. So, if I wanted most points per space, I would make more kitchens to get 150 points. So another cook, fire, and chest. And that much I could do. Those are pretty cheap. And Pippa is in her room, and you are going back to your room where you belong. Thank you. Maybe he just goes to the nearest one? I don't know. I don't know why he didn't actually... Why he came over here the other time. Instead, probably because I had broken it, actually. And so it reset his default to here. So let's not break the bedrooms again. Okay. Sleep. Bright and shiny day. We can, check. Do we get any... Oh, we got some plum berries. Okay. That's tasty. And in here, we got nothing. Nothing. Maybe they used the other chest. Oh, they did use the other chest. Okay. Straw door. Awesome. I'll take it, actually. Free door. We can make another room. I don't know where, but maybe we'll divide this gigantic one into something smaller. That seems kind of unnecessary. Put a little closet in the corner of it or something. I don't know. We'll do something. For now, I'm gonna save it up and we'll just wrap it up here. This has been fantastic. I've had so much fun with this game, and it's gonna be even more fun from here on out because we're gonna dive into the combat and hope I'm ready. Got oaken clubs. Should probably pair this one. Swap out our stick for another club. What else we got? Our ragged rags are doing okay. I guess they'll hold up. I don't know. I could make more with that that rough cloth out in the chest there. That's all you can do with that. But for now, we're going to save it up. And yes, this is the one. Do you want to overwrite? Yes, please. Okay, that'll do it. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you next time.